Parliamentarian Ranjit D'Souza says the Indian government should provide an explanation as to whether the Indian national under the custody of Criminal Investigation Department is an agent of the Research and Analyst Wing or RAW.
Attention was drawn towards an article carried by the Hindu about a statement said to have been made by President Maithripala Sirisena at the cabinet meeting last week. According to the report of the Hindu, President has mentioned the Indian national must be a RAW agent trying to kill me. Issuing a communique in response to the conundrum regarding the alleged assassination plot of the Sri Lankan president, the Indian Prime Minister's office said the reports are malicious. The communique said that the Sri Lankan president said the mischievous and malafide reports were utterly baseless and false.
This Indian national who was taken into custody came to my house twice looking for me as well. When we looked into who this person is, turns out that the name he produces in Sri Lanka is not the name he carries in the RAW organization. His name is Rajendra Kumar. Spies trained by RAW are given an identity card and an identity number. The identity number Rajendra Kumar is given by RAW is RB317217-VJ. Rajendra Kumar had first come to the country before the 2015 presidential election as a person seeking political refuge. He has since been working as a spy for RAW. He has been living here not by earning through a job, but with the money given to him by RAW. This is why the Indian High Commission was quick to state he was a mental patient the moment he was arrested.
Although certain political statements made by MP Vimal Veerawansa are questionable, one cannot simply disregard disinformation revealed by him. Neither the Indian government nor the Indian High Commission in Colombo has responded to the allegations made by Vimal Veerawansa. The Indian High Commission is responsible to inform if the Indian national is a RAW agent and deny these allegations. And when the CID is still questioning the Indian national, why isn't the Indian government coming forward to show reasons to release him? The government should make a statement saying he is not a spy and that this is a false allegation. Or Vimal Veerawansa should be arrested for making this statement. It is clear to us that no one is concerned about these statements about an alleged plot to assassinate the president and the former defense secretary by RAW. If MP Vimal Veerawansa says that the Indian national is a RAW agent or that he has information, Vimal Veerawansa should be questioned by the CID. The Indian High Commission has not responded yet. The Indian High Commission declared him as a person who was mentally ill as soon as he was arrested. There is a question as to how and on what basis the Indian High Commission made that statement. Meanwhile, the Hindu, quoting a press release issued by the Sri Lankan Prime Minister's office, said Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi had expressed concern over delays of a number of joint development projects with India. During Prime Minister Vikramasinghe's previous official visit to Delhi in April 2017, the two nations signed a memorandum of understanding between India and Sri Lanka for cooperation in economic projects. The pending projects include an LNG terminal in Kerulapitiya near Colombo, a 50 to 100 megawatt solar power plant in Sampur, an oil tank farm in Trincomalee and a container terminal in the Colombo port. The agreement also mentioned about the development of the Palali Airport in Jaffna and the Mathale Airport in Hambantota. The Indian Ministry of External Affairs said the Prime Minister's discussions were based on the progress of the projects and bilateral relations between the two countries. If an agreement was reached in 2017 with India to hand over certain things, why did they sign agreements with India to hand over the port city and the Hambantota port? Why did they decide to hand them over to China? It is clear that India is trying to interfere into these matters based on the fact that we violated the sovereignty of the country by handing these projects to China. Is the Sri Lankan government going to bow down to this? Is the government hoping to hand these over to these countries? The government should be able to deal with the resources of the people. That should be the duty of the government. That is what the people of this country expected in 2015. So we request the Prime Minister to protect and safeguard the resources of the people and not make decisions based on the thinking that we should give what India asks for or we should give India what we gave China.